I talked to a professor. She had said, you know, make sure that if you become a doctor that you interact with these people and have conversation with them, because for some people, maybe going out to the doctor is the only interaction they get all week. And it kind of made me open my eyes a little bit and gave me a new perspective. My name is Jacob Tupa. I'm from Larimore, North Dakota, and I'm a medical laboratory science major. I chose medical laboratory science because, like with anything, I was pretty sure I wanted to go to medical school, but I thought, well, what if I don't? I need to have a solid plan and I want to have a solid job, seeing how high in demand they are, seeing how ultimately they're the ones who really help you determine a diagnosis with a patient, with the lab testing and interpreting results. And it's an important part of the medical field that maybe doesn't get the exposure in certain television shows like people see, or like Grey's Anatomy, things like that. I've never seen it, but it made me think, wow, I can really truly make an impact on a patient's outcome without maybe necessarily being a doctor. And I figured it would give me a good science and lab background to help me for the future. I worked as a CNA through probably five to six months of the pandemic, because I worked in a nursing home. They're more vulnerable, and so the residents there, not being able to see their families, having to kind of be encouraged to be in their rooms away from others, it took a toll on them, and it's kind of tough as a care provider to see them not having that social interaction. I had quit working to start studying for the MCAT, and I always wanted to go back and see some of the residents and just be able to chat with them and maintain our relationships, but it's been tough with this pandemic. Loss of communication, that's what kind of inspired me. Well, maybe us as college students, we're looking for volunteer opportunities, and it's hard to volunteer in a pandemic because of the gatherings. Figured what better way to try to volunteer than to just write a letter. I mean, it takes 10, 15 minutes out of your day to write a letter and send it to a resident in the nursing home that I worked at. So we got around 40 volunteers to write letters, which is huge. Hopefully we can brighten their day with a letter. You know, everybody likes to get mail that's not bills.